Hey guys, Yuli here, creator and founder of parttimebusinessbuilder.com. And today I have a quick and simple message that I'm kind of doing a little, you know, I'm still stuck here in my hotel room in North Carolina. My flights got canceled last night, so I decided instead of being the victim and playing the victim and getting irate and angry about the situation, I just thought I'd make the best of it and enjoy the day here. I don't fly out till a little later this afternoon, so woke up a little early this morning, had some breakfast downstairs. I'm going to go work out for a little bit, and then I'll make my way over to the airport. But if you're one of those people that makes it a habit to play the victim, if something goes wrong all of a sudden, like a simple thing as far as a plane getting canceled and you have to spend another night in a hotel and you're looking for someone to blame, if you're that person and you're always having that conversation in your head about being the victim, then I want you to stick around because I got a really interesting video I want to show you, and then I got a couple points I want to make. So I'm going to try to keep this as brief as possible. So stay tuned and I'll be right back.
Do to my sign?
I wrote the same, but in different words.
Thanks, love.
Okay, so that's an extremely powerful video, and it's for a couple of reasons. Now, the first thing I want to say is that this is not my video. Obviously, a ton of you have seen this video before. I just wanted to frame the video, and I don't really know whose video it is, unfortunately, because through YouTube, there's just too many people out there. So I do want to credit the source. I just don't know who the source is exactly. But the very powerful thing about this video is that this older gentleman, this blind guy, was playing the victim. He was the victim. I'm blind. I need help. Please help me. And what he didn't realize is that a lot of people don't see that as, you know, how he's expressing it. What he's trying to express is, his actual emotions and his feelings. But a lot of people just see that as a handout. So what this young lady did was change the way he said the same exact thing by changing his words. And now that's extremely powerful because when you change your words, you change your world. So if you're constantly playing the victim, and this could be in any area of your life, it could be around your family, it could be around your spouse, it could be around your coworkers, it could be around your business, how you speak about money, how you speak about business, how you speak about your health and your fitness, the language that you use is going to determine exactly how the progression towards that topic in your life goes. So if you're constantly playing the victim and saying, oh, I don't have any money, or I hate my job, or I'm always stuck in traffic, or why me? Why is this always happening to me? If you're always in that mentality, that's the conversation that you're constantly having with yourself. Those are the results that you're constantly going to get. So it's as simple as changing one thing. It's as simple as changing the way you say it, or the way you talk about it, or the way you perceive it. If you're stuck in traffic, the second you start getting angry, you start realizing it starts rolling downhill. It's a downhill battle. But the second you are feeling that you're about to get angry in traffic, let's just, for example, you're in traffic, you're about to get angry, and you're about to be like, oh, God, I'm always stuck in traffic. If you go in that direction, that's the direction your day is going to go. If you're conscious about what you're about to say and about how you're about to say it, then that is your opportunity to cut that off. And the second you make that disconnection, the second you go, instead of going in this direction, you just veer off 1 degree in this direction, then you're going to see an incredible change in not only your attitude, you're going to start feeling better. The chemicals in your body that your brain releases are just going to flow in the direction of you detaching from the anger and moving in the direction of, it doesn't have to be joy or gladness, it just has to detach from that anger and do something else, you know, put on a good song or, you know, put on an audiobook or think about something that you're, you know, why, where are you going while you're in traffic? You say you're going to see a loved one, you know, think about that. Detach yourself from the anger and move yourself towards the pleasure. So that's going to move your life in a totally different direction. And even if it's only by a little bit, at the end of the day, that's going to separate you night and day between where you were going and where you're going now. So that's just one way to control what happens in your life and how to control the things that you do. So instead of playing the victim and always being, you know, I don't have this, I want this, I don't have this, I need this, change that conversation with yourself, because the most important conversation that you could possibly have is with yourself. So I want you to just take that with you today as you're going through. I know a lot of you are different time zones, but as you go through your day, as you progress through your day, if you're getting in that position where you're starting to get frustrated about something, or you're going to play the victim, or you're going to be the why is me or woe is me mentality, just disconnect right away. Just be conscious of that. Just be aware. Be aware of your thoughts. Be aware of your mind. Just control those things and then separate yourself. And I don't make guarantees, like I said before, but I have a sneaking suspicion that if you start to do that with your life and in every conversation that you have with yourself especially, things are going to start changing for the better. So, you know, change your words, change your world. So have a beautiful day and be able to enjoy it. All right, guys. Thanks again. Yuli Ribeiro, parttimebusinessbuilder.com. I hope that helped a little bit. I hope you got some value out of it. And if you did, please leave me a comment or send me an email or get connected with us somehow. And then we'll see you on the next video. All right, guys. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.